Check out what I just picked up on the side of the road on my way home from work this evening. This is a huge Sony Vega, I don't know. Sony high definition big old projection TV. I believe it's projection. It's got the fat back on the back. Well, you can't really see. Now you can see. It's not as big as some of the giant box ones that I've seen before, like that one I blew up one time. But I've been looking to pick up one of these. And obviously this thing's broken. I already plugged it in and tried to see if it would fire up, and it didn't. And who knows, there may be some value in it as far as trying to fix it and get it working, but I'm really not interested in that. The main thing I'm interested in is the getting a Fresnel lens out of it, and I'm hoping that there's one in this. I've never seen one scrapped on YouTube that's this size. They're usually those big giant box ones that are more square. This is, I think, is a newer design, but I think it's still a projection TV as far as I can tell. Anyway, I'm gonna break into this thing and see if I can find out, and hopefully I'll get a nice Fresnel lens out of this and be able to have some fun with it. Stay tuned. Jackpot. This is what I was looking for. This is a Fresnel lens, and it's a big one. Real big. I'm going to have a lot of fun with this thing. It's obviously late at night right now. I just got home from work. I'm glad I grabbed this on my way home from work. I tell you what, it was a pain getting this thing into my Expedition all by myself. There's a really nice mirror in here, and there's a there's some lenses right there that are, I guess, where it projects the image up onto the mirror and then out through the Fresnel lens. But anyway, I got it out all right. It wasn't as bad as I thought it was going to be. It was maybe 20 screws Phillips head, nothing too bad. Just kept taking screws out till I got where I wanted to get. And this thing is awesome. I can't wait to try it out next time I have a sunny day. Got a few little scratches on it. I hope that doesn't make a huge difference. I don't think it will, as big as this thing is. But it's just it's made out of plastic or some sort of, I mean, it's not glass or anything. It's amazing that plastic would magnify the heat of the sun the way those things do. I've seen videos on YouTube where these things just created like a death ray. There's a couple different types of Fresnel lenses, and there's one that creates a more dispersed heat beam. It's not as focused. And then there's some that are extremely focused, very, very fine focused point. And those things, I mean, are just incredible. If you just look up Fresnel lens on YouTube, you'll see exactly what I'm talking about. The real fine point is more desirable, but it's just kind of the luck of the draw of what you get. I don't know if there's certain brands or certain types of TVs that have them or what, but I haven't found that information online yet. But hopefully I have one of the more focused ones. We'll see. But even if it isn't a focused beam that this one creates, it's still going to be great for cooking and a lot of fun to play with. And it will, I mean, some of them are, they just vary in intensity, you know, different types. But you just kind of have to keep looking for them and trying them until you find some really good ones. But I'm real glad to get a hold of this one, and I can't wait to try it out. I don't know if I'll put up this video now or I'll splice it in with some of my testing on this thing later on. But anyway, appreciate you guys watching. Alright, so I got the Fresnel lens out, and it's a bright sunny day. There's a few clouds in the sky, but we got clear patches coming through, and it's real bright. I think before I was pronouncing it Fresnel lens, and it's actually spelled like Fresnel, but apparently Fresnel was the French guy who invented the Fresnel lens. They were originally invented for lighthouses. Of course, they weren't made out of plastic. They were made out of glass, but the principle was the same. So apparently it's pronounced Fresnel, not Fresnel. I always get it mixed up because it's spelled like Fresnel. Anyway,
I got a couple pieces of wood out here. I've already tested it out a little bit. You can see I charred it pretty good right there. We're going to try it again and see if we can't get a flame with this thing. Based on my initial impression, just testing it out to begin with, it doesn't look like this is going to be one of the ones that's like a death ray beam that'll, you know, instantaneous fire like I've seen some of them on YouTube. And I don't think it's because I have a linear lens. I think this is more or less a spot lens. And that's just has to do with the focus point and what the shape of it is. If you're not familiar with what a spot lens and a linear lens is, some of them make a linear hot spot. Some of them will make a single, very focused hot spot in a spot. So there's two different types. But some of them are more clear and let more light pass through, and some of them are more milky and cloudy like this one, and they don't let as much light pass through, and therefore they're not as intense. So it's still intense, don't get me wrong. It's just not as intense as some of the ones I've seen on YouTube that are like literally you can draw your name in wood very quickly, and it's just like a death ray. It's incredible. But so I'll keep looking, and I'll try to find, hopefully I'll be able to find one that's a more intense one, because I'd like to have one of those to play with. Excuse me, I'm getting over a cold. Anyway, but even if you don't have one of the super high intensity ones, they're still all great for cooking. And that's what I'll be planning to do with this one. I'm going to plan on building a stand for this one, and so I can set it up and do some solar cooking with it. I'll need to get me a Dutch oven, a cast iron Dutch oven as well. So anyway, let's get this thing up and test it out and see how it goes.
See smoke. I don't know if y'all can see that or not, but we're getting smoke and charring pretty easy, but not an outright flame. This thing is so big and flexible that it's difficult to hold it steady, and it flexes a lot. So I think I definitely need to build a stand for it. Obviously, if I'm gonna do any cooking, I'll definitely need that too. So that'll be one of my next projects, is building a stand for one of these, for this lens. And I think that'll make it be able to focus better and be more steady and more rigid and not flex so much. You can see the smoke going good now. It's definitely putting off some serious heat. A couple tips real quick. If you're going to try and do anything like this, be real careful. You're talking about temperatures exceeding 2,000 or 3,000 degrees potentially, and it will scald you. I mean, it will burn you bad. So don't play around with it, and be careful. Also, a good pair of glasses. That hot spot is really, really bright. And also, you'll notice on your Fresnel lens that one side is smooth and one side has a very, very, very tiny texturing. That's the Fresnel lens. That's what gives it the effect. You want that texturing to be towards the sun. If you have it backwards, it won't work at all. But we're putting out a lot of heat right there. Good hot spot. I'm curious to see, once I put this in a stand, what I'll be able to do with it, if it'll be more effective. And can't wait to do some cooking with this thing. But man, that thing is burning that wood. Not getting an outright flame though.
If you've never seen this before and you don't believe me, just do a search on YouTube for Fresnel lens and check out some of the videos. Just any of the top five videos, you'll see what I'm saying. people just showing this thing melting pennies and just instantaneous flame and like a death ray or something. It's incredible. Let me put it down so you can see. I don't know if the light's so bright, you might not even be able to see that wood. But it's definitely burning that wood. And that's nothing but the power of the sun focused. Pretty amazing. Anyway, I appreciate you guys watching, and y'all stay tuned. I'll be playing with this thing some more, building a stand for it, and I'll be keeping an eye out for more of these. I'd like to pick up a few more and hopefully find one that's a little bit more clear and more powerful, more focused, more of a instantaneous flame type one. I've seen them on YouTube. They're amazing. I mean, just ridiculous. So anyway, y'all have a great day. Appreciate you watching. All right, so it's a bright sunny day out here. It's between 12 and 1 midday, and I got the Fresnel lens out here. I think before I was referring to it as I just said it wrong again.